B-Monster Laboratory here. Today we're going to take a look at the SD1820 voice recorder module. It is cheap. We're going to solder it together and see how it does.
Today we're going to make a motion activated spy microphone with playback ability by adding a motion detector.
Just because it's cheap doesn't mean we can't have fun with it. So let's get it soldered up and see what we think.
For this project, I use the ISD1820 voice record and playback module. I bought that on Amazon, and it's currently $10 for three of them, so very cheap. You do have to solder the wires to the speaker, but that is all you have to solder. I'll also be using the HC-SR501 PIR sensor. It's an infrared sensor. It's a motion detector, motion sensor. I'm using that, and also a breadboard, and you can use whatever you want, but I'm going to use the Elegoo Uno. And I use some male-to-male jumpers and a couple of female-to-male jumpers for my motion sensor. And that's it. Back in the 90s, Tyco had a product called SpyTech, and I remember the commercials for that, but could never really afford it. So the idea of a motion-activated spy microphone sounds pretty cool, but just use it for entertainment purposes. Don't get yourself in trouble. Be sure to look for the positive and negative symbol on the back of your speaker so you know where to solder those wires. A little bit about the module before we start. This can be a freestanding or standalone voice recorder and playback. And to do that, you would provide power through the VCC in the ground over here. And you just hold the record button down and you would speak into or around or within the vicinity of this microphone right here. And when you want to play back, you press this button once and it will play back whatever you recorded. If you hold this button down, it will play back whatever you recorded until you let up on it. So if you just press it and let up, it'll just play just a brief second. If you want it to play the whole thing, you just hold it down. So that is the standalone option. And over here you have your pins for VCC is power. And there's a couple different data sheets. There's one on components 101 that says the VCC. Is 2.4 volt to 5.5 volt, but if you go to the allelectronics.com datasheet, it says that the VCC is 3.3 volt. I've been using the 5 volt option the entire time through the Elegoo Uno. So here we have ground pin, it goes to ground. The FT pin is for feed through, and this mode enables the microphone to drive the speaker directly. And then you have your record pin down here. This allows you to send an active high record signal to your board, and you can record that way. And here you have two pins, the PE and the PL button. That stands for playback E and playback L. Those are just two different ways that a playback cycle is initiated. One is level activated and the other one's edge activated. So those are your playback buttons. And then over here we have the SPI, the speaker plug, which we mentioned earlier, and then the microphone right here. And that is it for this module. Here's my setup. I'm using the breadboard on top of this platform here with a motion sensor mounted right here. And over here on my module, the VCC and the ground pin are connected to the breadboard rails right here, and those are connected to the 5 volt and ground pins of my Uno board. The FT pin here on my module is connected to pin 5. The PE pin on the module is the red jumper, and it's connected to pin 3. And the record pin is yellow, and it is connected to pin 2. Over here on the motion sensor, I have my positive jumper connected to the rail here, positive rail on the breadboard. My green pin is the sensor pin, the data pin, and it is connected to pin 8 on the Uno board. And then the white pin here is my ground pin, and it is connected to the ground rail right here, which all feeds right into the board. And that is it for the setup. And here is a schematic that shows you all the connections. When putting the code into the Arduino IDE, the first thing you want to do is go ahead and define each of the pins that are on the module. For record, we're going to set that or define that at pin 2. For the play button, we're going to use play E. We're going to define that at pin 3. The FT we'll define at pin 5. And we'll set a play time of 12 seconds and a record time of 10 seconds. And this play time value here will be 900, which will be equal to 0.9 seconds for the press and release playback time. Down here, you also want to define the motion sensor pin at pin 8, and the motion sensor state as low, and give it a value of 0. Down here in the setup, you want to set your record button, your play button, and your FT button, or pins, as outputs. And then you come down here and you set your input pin, which is our motion sensor pin, as an input. That looks kind of funny there, but that's what that means. And then we'll set up our serial monitor right here. Then down here in the loop, the first thing we'll do is read the value. If the value is high, it will record. It'll set the record pin high. It'll record for the record time, which is 10 seconds. And then this will be printed on the serial monitor. If it is low, the record pin will go low. It'll shut off, and you'll see motion ended. And then the PIR state, or the motion sensor state, will go low as well, and that'll shut off. Down here, this section gives you the option to go into the serial monitor and press P, little or big P, capital P, to play anything that you might have recorded manually on the module. And you'll see this here. If you press it, playback started or playback ended when it stops. And then down here, we also see that you can press lowercase or capital R in the serial monitor, which is right up here. I don't have it connected right now, but serial monitor right up there. You press small or capital R to record, and it will go into a recording state, and it will record for the record time that we put up here at the top. And then after that, the pin will go low and it will stop recording. So those are the record and playback options that we added at the end of our program. And now we can go take a look at it in action. Now I've got my code completed here, and we have the Uno connected to the computer. So whenever I make a motion in front of the motion sensor, when you see the red light come on the module, that means it's recording. When it goes off, that means it has stopped. And then I'll press this button for playback, and you'll hear it. The speaker's not that great, but you will hear it through the speaker. And right now, I'll just go ahead and load the program onto the board. You can see it loading. Now it is done. And when I make a motion, hello, 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 hello. It records for 10 seconds, and that goes off, and I press playback. And now it's stopped. And I can press this button just for partial. And it stopped. When I release, it stops. Now we can also go up here to the serial monitor, open that up, and we can record from there. So if we hit R, enter. Hello, hello, hello. Hello, hello, hello. Hello, hello, hello. and then it'll stop recording. Hit P for playback. Enter. So that is the serial monitor option for record and playback. These speakers a lot of the time do better if you put them in somewhere where they can kind of reverberate or whatever the word is for it, so that sound can bounce off of the compartment. And I'm just going to try this out. It may not work, but I have a little box here. I'm going to put the speaker just under this hole right here and then run it through this hole I cut in the side right here. We'll see how it works. Hello, hello, hello. Hello, hello, hello. Hello, hello. I don't know if you can tell, but it does sound a little bit better. I think a hard surface like plastic would make it sound even better. If you want to use this as a standalone record and playback module, you can just provide the power and the ground outlet off of the Uno or whatever. You can also use a breadboard power supply or battery pack. I'm using 5-volt here, so we can do that, and we can record by pressing the record button. Record, record, record. And then playback. You could use a nano, use smaller wires, shorter wires, and a battery pack, and pack it into something the size of this box, making your spy microphone compact and easy to use and to take anywhere. Overall, I was pretty happy with this. It is cheap, and it's just a learning module, but I was able to make an okay spy microphone, so I was pretty happy.
Well, that's all I've got for today. As always, thank you very much for watching. If you liked the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll see you again very soon.